Hello, good morning all. I hope you can hear me.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Good morning, ma'am. I have also joined.
Yes, ma'am. Hello. Good morning, madam. Madam, there was earlier meeting was going on, so that is why we couldn't start with this. I just contacted with the person who had arranged the the Zoom meeting. So now it's okay for us.
Okay,
ma'am.
Waiting,
ma'am. I have made you host, so you can make ma'am co-host and.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Okay. Ma'am. Then I can start. Shall I start the meeting, ma'am?
Yeah. I'll just have a formal introduction and all. Ma'am, just I'm waiting for our principal sir to join.
Okay, ma'am.
Madam, shall we start? I think sir is not picking up the call. Shall we start?
Okay. Good morning, Rita, madam.
Good morning, ma'am.
Madam Jayashree Vasai is our head of the Department of Statistics.
Okay, ma'am. Welcome.
Thank you, madam.
Welcome to you. Chaya, ma'am. Sir is still in the finance committee meeting. It has not ended.
Okay, this then we can start. We'll start. No problem. Okay.
I have made you co-host, host, so you can control the meeting and everything.
Yes. Thank you so much, DP, sir. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, DP. Ma'am.
I want to share the screen, madam. So
yes, I will make you host, ma'am. I will make you co-host so that you can do that. I'll just welcome all. Yeah, a very good morning to all. Today's guest speaker, respected Dr. Rita B from MGM Institute of Health Sciences, in absentia of Principal Dr. Himanshu Dauda, Head Department of Statistics, Professor Jayashree Vasai. My colleagues from my department, colleagues from other department, and my very dear students. Statistics is widely used in various fields such as business, agriculture, government, private sector, computer science, finance development, actuarial science. Many more are there, and one of them is health sciences. Statisticians are in great demand in clinical trials, laboratories, hospitals, pharmaceutical industries. And we just have a vague idea that they work at different levels, but don't know exactly what they do and their role as a biostatistician. To enlighten us about the same, today we have Dr. Rita B from MGM Institute of Health Sciences with us. I welcome you, ma'am, for today's program. And we are really eagerly waiting for you to listen to all these details from you. And just before that, I invite our sincere and well-organized student of class TYBSC, Ms. Jyoti, to introduce yourself, ma'am. So, Ms. Jyoti, are you there?
Yes, ma'am, yes.
Will you introduce
us? Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Good morning, one and all present here. Myself, Jyoti Pandey from TYBSC. I'm extremely honored and privileged for getting an opportunity to welcome today's guest, Dr. Rita Abhi, ma'am. Ma'am has completed MSc in Statistics and PhD in Statistics Applied. Ma'am has also done Diploma in Computer Programming and MBA. She is currently a professor and the HOD of Biostatistics at MGM Institute of Health Sciences. Ma'am has a great experience of more than 40 years, mainly in research, teaching, consultancy and administration. Along with these, ma'am has a great knowledge of technologies and software like analytics, SPSS, Minitab, SAS, and Bibo, and many more. She is a board member and guest faculty at various institutes or colleges. Also, she is a member of various scientific and ethical committees and professional organizations at national and international level. She is a PhD guide for biostatistics and applied statistics. More than 100 papers published and presented at international and national level under her guidance. Also published more than 20 reports of various subjects under her guidance. Ma'am is also doing something in favor of our society. She has visited many countries such as USA, UK, Australia, New Zealand, Japan, China, Africa, Singapore, and Scandinavia. The presence of such a personality among us itself is a blessing. So once again, we welcome you, ma'am, and request you to begin your session. We are eagerly waiting to listen to you.
Thank you so much for such a wonderful introduction in so much of detail. So I think without wasting time, I'll start. So the idea here is to give you that what exactly the biostatistician do, what kind of a problems they solve, or what question they answer. So just wanted you to get aware about that, because earlier there, this was, you know, like statistics is just used as a number crunching, and very few people were aware of that. But now its scope is getting wider.
Madam, excuse me, may I just disturb you? Can you make me a co-host, madam, so that I can record? Because this recording is, I don't know whether it is on. It is on, but it might have little problem later on. Will you just make me co-host, ma'am, please?
Ma'am, you want me to admit the student? What do you want?
No, there is one. You can go to participants. In participants, you can see room number 9.
Okay, participants.
Can you see room number 9 in participants?
Room number 9.
Yeah. Will you just go to more and make me co-host?
More. Make co-host.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, that's it. Thank you so much, ma'am. Ma'am, please continue.
Okay. So, what I feel, because I also believe in, you know, like to improve the health of the community and health, and so that is the major role. So, I feel that a biostatistician is not only involved in his his profession, but in a way he is improving the health of the individual and the community. So that's a community services. Now, how do they do? So that is, you know, like the mention, they will identify the problem, develop the model, estimate the cause and effects, what are the risk factor, how to design the study, what will be the interpretation of the results. And like that, they develop n number of statistical methodology or models, and then answer to the questions in the field of biostatistics. So role of biostatistics is very vast. It is not only, you know, like related to biology, but n number of fields like physiology and anatomy, pharmacology, medicine, community medicine, public health, then biotechnology, genetics, nutrition, clinical nutrition. Then there are biomedical science. By biomedical science, I mean the molecular biology, the biochemistry, and so on. Okay, the courses in anatomy and physiology and all that. Then physiotherapy, nursing, dental, because all these professions have their own branches, and they are into detailed, need a detailed and advanced level of biostatistics. And there are many other fields. So just give you an example, what exactly the biostatistician do. So let us take the example of physiology and anatomy. Now, as you know, we know what is the normal pulse rate. So this normality, the norms are defined by the biostatistician, the range, what should be the normal blood pressure, how much is the range of that. So all these things are a scope of biostatistics. And if we look at, suppose there are two regions, one is Gujarat and another is Punjab. So what is the difference in the mean or the proportion of the two places? Why there is a difference? Maybe it is due to the nutrition, or it can be anything. So that's how we find out the region based. Then next one is, you know, like suppose if we want to see the correlation between the two locations, like what are the reasons of these two locations regarding the growth of the population. Is the height is, you know, like weight is increasing in proportion to the height, or they are obese or they are malnourished? What is the relationship? How we can figure it out, and what are the cause and how it can be improved? What are the other factors involved in it? So that is what in like a simple example of physiology and anatomy. Now coming to pharmacology. So pharmacology, as you know, the clinical trial. So first of all, what we do, we try on the animals or say human beings, and then we try to find out what is the effect of our drug, whether our drug is improved compared to the standard drug or not, or whether there is a difference between two successive dosage. This one dose is enough, or after the second dose, the things are enough. Because nowadays this pandemic has, you know, like increased the knowledge of clinical trial, vaccination and all that in the population. So coming to medicine, in case of medicine, you know, like what should be the line of treatment, how to compare the efficacy of a particular drug, or what operation should be, you know, like performed. So whether the patient is cured or relieved from the pain, or whether he died. So there is a comparison between experimental group and the control group. Moreover, we want to find the association. Is there any association between smoking and the cancer? So that all such things, you know, like involves the biostatistics. Not only that, suppose we want to identify the signs or symptoms of a disease. So we see in typhoid, the temperature is always there, but if the patient is coughing, so is cough is a part of the symptom of the typhoid, or it is by chance. So all such things involved. Because I'm just giving you a very, very simple examples, but there are, you know, lots and lots of measurement symptoms are available. So one can usually consider all those factors. So in public health, as we see, say to test the useful of sera that is lacking in iodine. So whether iodine is less or it is sufficient in a population, in a target population. So that can be done, whether it is vaccinated versus unvaccinated can be compared. Then what are the causes and effect of it? Because we are not just ending up at the result. What are the causes? What are the effect of this? What are the disease? Why it is happening? So all such, you know, like part of the epidemiology, that is a branch of a public health only. So I'll just present you some of the questions which can be answered by a biostatistician or using the biostatistical methods. So normally the questions are, is breastfeeding by HIV positive mother is associated with infant mortality, or is the hormone replacement therapy associated with the heart disease or stroke? Okay. Then do the patient taking Vioxx have increased the risk of stroke? Then how are the MRI brain scan for schizophrenic patients or different for the other people with disease or without disease? Okay, so all such questions can be answered by using biostatistical methods. So does the moderate alcohol intake reduce the risk of cardiovascular disease? is because I'm not getting into that how biostatistical methods are used and what all are required. I'm just putting the question and answers will be given by using the biostatistical methods. So is the male circumcisions associated with the decreased disease of AIDS, or is the new pharmaceutical effective in lowering LDL? Is the cystic fibrosis patient is a specific gene variation associated with more severe disease, or are drinking water byproduct associated with miscarriages? So the typical activities of a biostatistician is very first question, there is a lot of importance of the sample size. How much should I have? So there are n number of methods for selecting the sample size. So once you decide the sample size, what is your target population? Then the medical studies are the costly affair, so they need a grant. So how to write a proposal for the grant? What are the sampling method we are using? What is the study design? What kind of analysis we are going to perform? So all these randomization, sampling design, interim analysis, then financial analysis, whether the project is viable. So that kind of analysis, like how much fund we will be needing it, then the descriptive and inferential statistics and how to write the report and submit to the organization from whom the fund is required and into the scientific community. So all these involve the method of biostatistics. Now, research in biostatistics. So we do collaborate with the other institute, units. So collaboration on studies leads to the need to develop new methods for the analysis. So the correlated data, longitudinal data, missing data, how to treat it. So censored data, all these are the topics for the research, and lot of research is going on this. Now I'm just coming back to about our course. In this institute, the course is of 2 years, which consists of 4 semesters. So if somebody is interested in health sciences, can go to the website and opt for such course. So I'm not getting much into detail, but of course, these are not so simple. You are also going to learn along with this, the statistical packages, to help you to do the advanced statistical analysis like SPSSR and all that. The eligibility criteria for the course is 50% marks in the bachelor degree and at least 2 full papers of mathematics or statistics during their graduation period. So that is the requirement. Now, what are the career opportunities? As madam has already mentioned that there is a lot of demand of statisticians. So in the same way, the health sector is expanding. And, from one body or one cell, there are hundreds and hundreds, I think billions of measurements are available. Molecular level, then, cell level and all that. So if more and more data is available, you can explore the more the techniques and you can find out what are the cause and effect. For example, initially, breast cancer used to be one disease. Then thereafter, there are 4 or 5 type of breast cancers are there. And then if the lady comes, so clinician treat them accordingly, like what type of a blood breast cancer she is having. But now, which is not so, as so much of data is available, so each patient has a different type of breast cancer. So accordingly, the treatment can be given and patient get relief from that. So that is, you know, the small example I have given that can be, you know, like a very vast field in this bio role of biostatistician. So where do the biostatistician works? The pharmaceutical companies, research institutes, hospitals, public health. Then if you want to go into academic, then the medical, of course, is there. That also include nursing, dental, physiotherapy, and biomedical sciences college. Then the government sector, non-profit organizations, chemical and biotechnology industries, insurance companies, technology companies, and lot of private companies. So in the private sector. So today, biostatisticians offer lucrative salaries and a variety of projects that go beyond simple number crunching, and yet few people in the scientific community are aware of it. So the current demand of biostatistician, not only in US but in India as well, it is far exceeds the supply, and the gap expected to continue to widen. In last 20 years, the demand of biostatistician has grown dramatically, and the role of biostatistician and biostatistics in design, conduct, and the analysis of biomedical research has continued to expand. So, because earlier, you know, like people were not even aware that such branch is there, and still, I think in Mumbai, there is hardly... This is the one of the college which is having this, and another one IIPS is having. So they have a degree with demography and biostatistics. So the rising stature of statisticians who can earn a top companies in their first year after getting the doctorate, like if you are PhD, you can be a CEO of the company. So it is a byproduct of the recent explosion of the digital data. Lots and lot of amount of data is available, but what is the missing link? The missing link is the statistical technique. The data is available. People feel that if we get the data, we will get the result, but which is not that. So it needs the statistical models, the algorithms. So what is the beauty of biostatistics? It turns the boring number into the exciting stories. So it has a huge impact. For example, it provides key insights for policymakers to make priorities for social resource allocation or for medical practitioners to practice with evidence-based findings. So biostatistics is a relevant, high impact, rewarding field if you have a strong quantitative ability and interest in application to public health. So then only you should go for a career in biostatistics. So your interest should be there in the health sector. Now, regarding the jobs, job hunting. Right now, see, we have this is the second batch is going to pass, but there is a 100% placement for that. The one student is, she's a biostatistician in Indoja Hospital. So anyway, so this, all this jobs are 100%, you know, like these degrees are 100% placement will be there. Like, nobody will sit at home after doing this degree. So these are the several website of the job which I have downloaded from the Google. And then if you look at, there are further 285 jobs in India. So like that, so there are a lot of jobs available, and nowadays every hospital is keeping a biostatisticians. Since biostatisticians are not available, so they are keeping the statistician, and thereafter statistician learn the biological field and then they can perform in that field. But here directly the applications are there, so it's a more of an applied field. So that's why this degree should be there. And this is just a short story of a role of biostatistics and its career opportunity. So with this, madam, I would like to conclude this session. Now it is open for question answer. If anybody has any questions or any query, you are most welcome. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, yes.
Okay.
Yes, yes. Yes, students, do you have any questions regarding this job opportunity or any career in biostatistics area? Maybe clinical trials. You know a little bit about clinical trials and bioequivalence. Related to that, if you want to do your career, you can think about it and you can ask your queries to madam. Madam is the right person actually to answer your queries.
And even those who want to do PhD can, you know, like,
yes,
of course, you are a graduate student, so the PhD is also available.
Yes.
And it's it depends on the interest. We find it because it's an applied field. Everyone, it's, you know, like apply to yourself, because all of us one time or other need a medical help.
Yes.
So naturally, there is a curiosity that what it is, you know, like why it is, why this disease and all that. So it automatically develops the interest. But whether you want to make it profession or not, it's up to you.
Yes. One of our student is doing MSc over there. Huh? Students, you can ask that student also. She is doing MSc in biostatistics in MGM Institute of Health Science.
Yeah, yeah. I forgot to invite her, actually. Yes. I told her that I'll invite you.
I thought she will also join. Yeah. 2 years back, she had completed a BSc from our college. And now she is doing MSc under her, under madam's guidance.
She has almost completed, now submitting her dissertation. Her dissertation is on the topic, the method of use of contraceptive methods and its effect on the socioeconomic and demographic profile. So what are the factors which, you know, like cause or effect for using the contraceptive method, whether it's education of the person, it's media and all such things. And she's working for the National Family Health Survey data, which is consist of almost 13 lakh household and 7 lakhs respondent, 6,99,000 something. So they are practicing on, how to clean the data, which are the validate, how to combine the data, you know, like various yes. factors, which is going to be their profession.
Yes. Madam, there is a question in chat that, madam, how can a biostatistician can says about the treatment of a person who have a disease?
Who have a disease? Okay, it is based on the data. See, biostatisticians work with the data, so data is available now. See, I have given the example of typhoid. Okay, so whether the person is having all the time fever, so these kind of a data is available. Whether he is having cough, what is his, you know, like CBC of the blood, all such things will be available. So based on that, one can, you know, like this is the healthy population and these are the disease population. And disease among the disease, which are the disease population? Like which type of disease?
Okay, okay. Yes, anybody has any other question? You can get your doubts clear with madam. That is all, students. May I request students to just put on your cameras, even to ma'am also. Madam, will you just switch on your camera so that we can take a group photo of all the members?
Ma'am, there is a problem with my camera. Okay. Otherwise, normally, I don't know, somehow it's not working.
Okay, madam, no issues. Yes, students, will you just put on your cameras? all the students put on your camera so that we can take a group photo. So it will be a good memory for us. Yes, thank you so much.
Thank you, madam.
I will request our one of our very good, well-behaved and proactive student, Miss Dikshita Kandari, to propose a formal vote of thanks. Yes, Dikshita.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Yeah, I hope you all enjoyed this information section. On behalf of Department of Statistics of RJ College, I, Dikshita Kandari from TYBSC, want to give a really heartfelt vote of thanks to our guest, Dr. Rita Abhi, who spent her busiest time for gracing the occasion. Today, we had the opportunity to hear your thoughts, and this is definitely encouraging us in our future events. And also, your thoughts have enlightened our minds and show us a new path. As you focused on very important aspects of our career and job opportunity, it will help us a lot in future. You educate us about how biostatisticians improve the health of individual and community, research in biostatistics, typical activities of biostatisticians, etc. Clear our idea in this field. The way you explain about what does a biostatistician do and how does it play an important role in medical research is going to be very helpful in our future. Thank you, ma'am, once again for such a great and informative session. Also, thanks to Director of Hindi Vidya Prachar Samiti, Dr. Usha Mukundan, for encouraging us at every step. A special mention to our venerable principal, Dr. Himanshu Davda, for constant support of all activities of department. With deep sense of appreciation, we thank our loving teachers for their untiring efforts. I would also like to thank our placement manager, Devi Prasad Shetty sir, for arranging this meeting. Last but not the least, thanks to all students for being present for this guest lecture. I'm sure it has given you a path to go ahead in your career. Once again, and thank you all for pleasant cooperation. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much for your lovely vote of thanks. Okay, thank you, Pingya madam, especially, you know, like for accepting this and giving me the opportunity to, so that students should get aware of it. Okay. So can I leave, ma'am?
Yes. Thank you so much.